I've always enjoyed helping people, so if I can use my profile and my skills to promote causes that are valuable to me and raise money, then that makes me feel good.
The BMW M4 is enormously fast, handles incredibly well, and has enough space to make it usable every day. What's more, for this kind of car, it's actually quite well priced.
Underneath there is a 2-litre diesel pushing out 175 brake horsepower. So, let's see how it drives.
I've just enjoyed a very picturesque 20-minute boat ride from Henley-on-Thames to the beautiful Temple Island.
In addition to the engine and bodywork checks that I do on cars that come to me in part exchange, there are a few things that you can do when driving. For example, you need to test the clutch. So get it into a low gear, get it into quite high revs, change into a higher gear. This one's fine, but if you've got all the revs and you're not going anywhere, your clutch is slipping. What I'm doing is putting it on full lock, making sure that the power steering pump isn't making any nasty noises and the drive shafts aren't knocking.
I recently invited a group of injured troops to one of my race weekends and managed to secure them a ride in a safety car.
Believe it or not, its roots date back to 1965 when Porsche made the first 911 Targa. The idea is to combine the best elements of a coupe and a cabriolet.
This car is rough and ready. The suspension is stiff, the four-wheel drive means it grips the road incredibly in the wet, and the powerful engine just encourages you to take full advantage of its fire-breathing nature.
First circuit that I attended, where I did my race license, where I did my first race, and that brings us today where we've got brilliant hospitality, and I really do appreciate you being here today.
We've come to the point where we really need to rank these cars in order of our preference. So,
for me, the Kia has to be third. Although it offers great value, it lacks the polish that the other two have.
You know what, you're absolutely right.
If they had more experience behind the wheel and they were unable to drive on the road for a little bit longer before taking their test, then they would be able to assess the road better.
Got bigger brakes from High Spec Motorsport, and Michelin tyres have dramatically improved the handling of the car as well. So it's a completely different beast now, and I absolutely love driving it.
A Seat Leon, for example, may not be quite as spacious, but it is a lot cheaper. Famous for winning several World Rally Championships, the fire-breathing monster that is the Subaru Impreza WRX STI has been lying dormant for a few years. But now, it's back. It's dropped the Impreza name. Does that mean it's not worthy? Or is it better than it's ever been?